Hi everyone, my name is Arvind and he is Utkarsh. We are from the company called Career Hunt. So before he starts the formal presentation, I just want to share the story of how Career Hunt evolved. So 8 years back, I started a Facebook group answering questions on GATE computer science topics, and now it has reached 3 lakh members. Okay, and over this period of time, okay, what I found is like lot of people are using internet to learn. Okay, this is a concept of micro learning, and now it has become famous because of the video is becoming popular means of learning. So what we thought is like we can formalize this and take it to the next way forward. So that's how it started, and Uka should be presenting.
Yeah, thanks Arvind. So I take care of product marketing and strategy at Career Hunt, and like Arvind said, it all started 7-8 years back when Arvind was in ISC, and today we realized a year back that we had grown to about 3 lakh members on Facebook. So we thought, I worked with Arvind in radio, so we brainstormed and I joined forces with him, and we are now trying to get it out into a full-blown website, portal and all the other media available. So the philosophy, as we've stated here, is that we know there are a lot of course creators and mentors who create a lot of content, but like as you mentioned, that if a company is so big on R&D and producing the thing, then they might not be as good in distribution and marketing. So that's where we try to pitch in, that you focus on what you do best and we'll try to deliver the results to a wider audience, and in the process we will make it much cheaper for you. So like I said, the problem we saw is that these companies who create a lot of content, they have to spend a bomb on marketing, and it's not always effective. Sometimes they may purchase email databases which are pretty outdated, and we have had cases that when people organize some webinars, they spend a bomb on email marketing, but none of the participants turned up, and all of the participants were the ones whose lead we had generated for them. As well as you'll see, SEO and all these techniques take a long time, and also you need a expert in-house or you have to pay a third party for that. So all of these combined create a big problem and challenge for the teams who do not have a co-founder most of the times well versed in all of these things. So what we are trying to do is we are trying to provide an in-house targeted marketing, because if you have to go to Google all the time or Facebook to get a lead, it will cost you a bomb on this. So what we are trying to do is we are trying to engage the community on one hand in our platform, and so that we market to them, and that doesn't cost us a lot. So we have a community of mentors, leaders, who we are calling leaders. As I said, we already have 3 lakh member strong Facebook community. It has got 80,000-90,000 active members monthly, and those other people we are calling leaders. We have a lot of what we call micro conversations going on. The technologies are evolving all the time. We have machine learning. It's not taught in universities. So where does a participant learn it? So we encourage, Arvind is well-versed in technology. I take care of some other disciplines. So what we are focusing on is to get the dialogue going. We have active WhatsApp groups, which have 4,000 participants all the time exchanging information. So we have the people sitting on the platform. And what we are trying to do now is, we have a lot of sponsors and training institutes, even startups have hired through us. They come, they reach out through webinars, through a lot of other methods. As I said, this is the time a lot of content is being generated, and a lot of that is in new emerging technologies. Microlearning is coming up in a big way. We are trying to provide a lot of tools, like audio tools on our platform, where people can come and record 1 minute videos, 2 minute videos or audio lessons. That gets the interaction going. And we have a very loyal, engaged and trusting community already. So the engagement is there, the point. This is one of the Facebook graphs you could see. We've got about 83,000 active members last month. You might have liked to have a look. Going forward, as I said, a lot of new technologies coming up. You can no more rely just on university education. It's a dynamic world. Things are changing before you notice. So we need a place where a dynamic dialogue is on, and video-based learning is catching up. We have these competitors, but we we have different areas than their expertise. We are mostly in tech. And this is a roadmap I already spoke about. The business model is we have already got sponsors. We've got advertisement revenues already. We are trying to get some native advertisement going. And this is about the team. I joined forces with Arvin last year. He's been doing it for the last 7 years. So the need is probably to expand in various ways, not just to get monetary help. Like I have connected with Tanjal already so that you can see how we can work together.
You mentioned it's been existing for 7 years.
Yeah, the Facebook group was started by 7 years.
When was the actual start of the whole company?
The portal was launched in 2016.
So you are basically dependent upon this group for all your lead generation. How does it happen?
Yeah, so the group is nurtured, but now we are expanding through Google Display Network. So we have our cost per acquisition is very competitive. So the group is serving as an engine to take the conversation forward. But we also get a lot of crowd through traditional marketing sources like, but there has to be some conversation going on already.
So you're dependent upon the group.
So group is one channel. So we have via email marketing, we have our website that brings us.
So there is an assumption that the group members would be promoting your business.
No, the group members would be validating the content. We use the that validation of this is the good content, then we can submit to other channels.
So the group validates. So how do you generate leads? I'm just trying to understand how do you generate these leads.
Yeah. Maybe if you walk through a typical example, it will
use case or something.
So I'll tell you. So basically how it started is on Facebook, we used to post something. Then a lot of students would engage. Then a lot of training institutes approached us who have a new course coming, but they don't know where to find the students. Okay. So we gave them a platform, like through a webinar maybe. We sent out a mail to our group. And we realized a lot of people were interested to learn about that. And we had these webinars where for a 2 hour session, nobody left. There were participants all through the webinar, which converted in even recruitment for the supply side. So because the group is so so focused that it leads to good conversions. But now we are trying to incorporate more and more of volumes.
You have no problem opposite Facebook. You are using the group for your commercial things. Facebook has no problem.
No, Facebook group is different from Facebook pages. So groups are allowed to engage and also advertise. That's not a problem.
Tomorrow there is always a risk that there is a
problem. That's why now the portal is the mainstay.
Yeah,
so we launch it.
The group, we don't do any promotional activities. We use the group to see like what kind of conversation people are engaging in and use that to push to other channels like email marketing.
So the conversations are usually around careers, career hunters.
Yeah,
around careers. Jobs.
It gets very technical also.
Which is
during the
data
exam.
For example, like which is the best place to learn machine learning?
So there's a political leaders will use your platform to advertise things, voting, things like that.
But that is not relevant. The target audience is mostly technology.
In our group, we don't allow any.
Who exactly is your customer? I still haven't got it. Who's your customer?
Training institutes, course providers. So there's a massive shift. Now people are producing online content as training institutes and charging as high as 30,000 rupees for 50 hour video content in machine learning. They have the content, but they don't have any marketing approach lead to the real consumers of it.
Some of the things are very overlapping with the previous startups, so that's a great deal. Tell more about it. The same problem as they face. Okay, like coaching institute have a lot of content, but they don't have a way of distribution. So we are solving the same.